Hello and welcome to another draft here on this channel. So here we have another Wilds of Eldraine draft. An interesting pick here. Rare is Heartflame Duelist. Solid removal spell on the 3/1. Gives instant sorceries lifelink. Really powerful if you can play it both. Force Truition. A risky card if they don't have enchantment removal in their first top like seven cards or in their opening or in their hand. When you play this, you're probably going to win, which is Vanity, Fantastic Saga, kills a little creature, gives you a food, gives you a Wicked Roll, tons of value, Ruby, great card for the green black deck, Shatter the Oath. I think I'm going to take Heartflame Duelist. I would play this in red. No matter what, wow, another Force Erosion. And another Witch's Vanity. Another Force. Yeah. And a cut in? There's also another white adventure card that the adventure part is better. Although, the white card, white part of this card is solid too. Creature that gives a creature +2/+2. DTBs. I think I might take Witch's Vanity or cut in here. I'm about to take another white card, but that doesn't seem super worth it. Heartflame Duelist is already kind of a red card, but I think the Witch's Vanity is fantastic. Gives you so much value and so much to bargain with. I'm just gonna take the best card in the pack, and I think that's Vanity. Sucks that we just passed one, but guns the brakes. Okay. Now we have some decisions. There's a Frolic Familiar, which would go great in the blue-red spell deck. But also, its adventure is just pretty good. Like, one damage to any target for 1 mana is just good in this format. Well, Rat Out is good. Red Tooth Vanguard, pretty good. Not very good against this kind of stuff, but it comes back eventually. There's an Obira for the blue-black fairy deck. Don't know if that's really what I want to be doing. There's a cut, another cut in, go with the Duelist, Sprite, Catapult to like really go in all the spells deck. But I think the Familiar is the best pick here. Familiar and cut in. I like how the Familiar gives me outs to be blue red. I don't know if I really want to be. I'm gonna take Obira. Let's take the good gold card and see where it takes us. Okay. This pack is not that great. There's like Edgewall Pack, Vermin. These green cards are not very good at all. Guard is not that good. Apple is an interesting card, but it's not something I can combo with, and there's a Not Dead after all. But I think the best card here is Gadabix First Duel. This card just does a lot for a saga. Create a Cursed Roll, Scry 2. And then copy your next instant or sorcery of mana value 3 or less. Pretty sweet. And it kind of fits into the blue-black thing we have going here. Hope I don't regret this Obira. But pick 3 Obira. Could be a signal. Oh, wow. Okay. Now there's some really good green cards in this pack. How do I connect green to all this? I think the two best cards in the pack are green. Royal Treatment. Fantastic protection spell, leaves behind a royal roll. Hamlet Glutton. Bargain is really easy. You barely have to do any work to turn it on, and this thing is a 5 mana 6/6. It's just fantastic. I think I might take that. I'm not sure which other color to pair it with. Maybe blue. Maybe if I see green and blue payoffs. Okay. Well, green-red is doable, too. Could take Flick Coin. I do like that card quite a bit. Conceited Witch is better than it looks on both sides. The draw two, the Vanguard. I might just take the Vanguard. Green's the only color that looks like it is open right now. So, yeah, pick 6 green uncommon. Seems like a good sign to me. Okay, well now there's. Oh, okay. Now there's cooped up. Pick seven, cooped up. I like that. Could be going to a green white. Sleight of hand's okay in green blue. Don't need to be green blue. Witchstalker is like probably a green black, green red card, or just a defensive thing. Think I'd rather have removal here. Merry Bards is better than it looks, and it is two permanents if you pay four. We're gonna take a cooped up. And then follow it up with some decent red cards here. Dragon Mantle. I don't really have any. I mean, this is a red card. It's also a white card. I'll probably end up splashing the red. I'll take Archon's Glory. This card just does a lot for two mana. Plus it bargains. Plus it can gain you life and finish them off. Yeah, like it fine here. Okay, now what? Now there's a Grabby Giant. Good red card. Good black card. Pretty good black card. These green cards are not really that good. I'm gonna take the Crystal Grotto here. I already have an off-color adventure that I kind of want to splash, probably. Sabira is not gonna get played, I don't think. Seems like a good place to pick up a Crystal Grotto. Okay, so now First Fruition came back. That card seems really incredibly risky. We'll just take Candy Trail. I love Candy Trail. It's an artifact that you can bargain. You don't feel too bad about it because the scry two is great. And also, it's a food clue. But there are pretty good red cards there, so. Oh wow, Catapult came back. I think it's too late for me to take Catapult, but happy to get another Vanguard here. Alright. Green something. No white cards here. Thief is pretty good. Yeah, I like it better than the other cards. Not really seeing black signals either. Okay, Darling Lounge Ranger. Okay. Alright, red, green, or green, white, I think is where we're going here. Lord Skitter. That card's really good. But you know what other card's really good? The Princess Takes Flight. It's not that good if you get to chapter 3, but you bargain it with, like, Glutton. Or like Glory, then they never get their creature back. You can blink your own creature too if you want, like if there's an aura on it. I think that's a good pick. Lord Skitter is the best card here, but black hasn't really appeared to be that open. There's also Lord Skitter's Butcher, is another fantastic black card. There's a Glutton here, but I think I'm gonna take the Princess Takes Flight. Wait, am I gonna take the Glutton here? No. I'll take the Princess Takes Flight. Alright. Gingerbread Hunter. Gingerbread Hunter is a black, green card, and it's fantastic. And its adventure is good too. This is one of the best uncommons in the set. Pretty happy to take that. Well, now I feel like I could have been green black. I think we're committing to. We're pretty close to committing to. Wow. We actually could be red white. Almost. But there's not really good red white cards here besides Firebolt. I'm just taking the Gingerbread Hunter. Okay, there's another Obira. It's a Picnic Ruiner, which is a really good green red card that I like. Yeah, I mean, I don't need to play Cooped Up. This I can play in any deck. Princess Takes Flight is good, but I'm not super enabling it yet. Return from the Wilds is interesting because it fixes for whatever color I'm splashing, plus it sets up Glutton for turn four, no matter what. I just like Picnic Ruiner a lot. It's a good card. I'm taking Ruiner, it has the highest upside. We'll wield one of these. Green card. We won't play Primal Vigor though. Okay. Now there's like a Bruiser, Candy Trail, Witch Doctor. For Knightly Valor, if we stay white. Maybe I take the Knightly Valor. I don't really care about these other cards except for Candy Trail. This is the safest pick as Candy Trail. Green White doesn't really want Armory Mice, I don't think. Yeah, I'll take a chance on Knightly Valor. Because I don't know what kind of green deck we are yet. Oh, okay. Well, now there's a Cooped Up. And there's a Financier. There's Brave the Wilds. And a Cut-In? Jeez. It's a good pack. Well, I can play green-white, and I can splash red for these. Seems like the best thing I could be doing. Hopefully I get some aura payoffs, like the one that draws cards when you make an aura. Would be awesome for a start like this. That's not it, though. Okay. Well, this is exciting. Am I taking Scarecrow Guide here? These cards aren't even that good in green-red or white-green. Yeah, I guess I'm taking Scarecrow Guide. I don't think I want to play it, though. They're really drying up here. Okay, there's a Knight of Doves, which is good with the Cooped Up, the Saga, possibly the Valor. Okay. This is more of a black-white card than it is a green-white card, but you can still get some pretty good value in green-white. Ooh. We get a Glutton pick 8 here. Are we going to get the pick 9 Glutton too? I probably play 3. Nope, don't get that one back. Alright. There's a Apple. Don't really have any way to make use of the Apple. Sideboard card. Grave Bombardment. Well, Reindeer could be okay for like aggressive green white, but I don't know how aggressive we want to be. Okay. Commune? That's a pretty late Snare Master sprite, I think. Savior of the Sleeping, Protective Parents. I think Savior is going to be pretty okay with our Cooped Up Sin Apprentice Takes Flight. Another one. Okay, we get the Armory Mice anyway. Sure. So we didn't wheel any of those other green cards, but we did get incredibly late Glutton. Okay, well now there's like Tempest Heart, it's not really for us. There's a Fawn. I like Curse of the Werefox, but my removal's already like pretty good. I'm gonna take Bramble Familiar. Is that better than Fawn? Fawn fixes my colors. I'm probably not gonna cast Fetch Quest. It might be Fawn, honestly. Honestly, I think Fawn might be the answer. Milling 7 is pretty dangerous. Get the Scarecrow Guide out of here. Griffin Airy. Is that going to be good? Trillion, not really what we're looking for. There's a Scavenger, that's pretty good. Gingerbrut. So Griffin Airy works with Candy Trail. And not this yet. Not really. Yeah, I think I take Hollow Scavenger here. Doesn't have much synergy with what we're doing, but it's just like a good green card. Ooh. Vanguard, but there's a Tanglespan Lookout. I have to take that. That's the card I've been looking for green white. Although this is good in every green archetype I've found. There's just enough auras between rolls and stuff that it's just great. Alright, now we take this and we take four things higher like this. Lookout. That. Alright. I would like more like cheaper bargain stuff. Because right now, if I play Princess on 4. Then I can play Glutton on 5. And bargain it. Get full value. Ooh, Curse of the Werefox. Celebrant would be pretty sweet, and I might consider taking it because it's great with Princess Egg's Flight here, but with Tanglespan Lookout and big creatures and bargain stuff, I just want Curse of the Werefox. Then it just turns into a removal spell that draws a card. And that's fantastic. Ooh, Acolyte. This is an oof. Bloodlines, but Acolyte's gonna be great here. All right, I'm liking where this is going. Ooh, Cursed Courtier. Let's see. We can bargain the curse three ways. Plus, we can. We have one way to give it a different role right now. That'll be better than another Vanguard. Yeah, sure. I said we'll draw a card with our lookout. Like, if you make this into a 3/3, or if you put a different roll on it, it becomes a 4/4 lifelink. That's huge. It's actually huge value. I think right now we're playing one Crystal Grotto. Ooh, there we go. That's perfect. It's a good creature, fills in our four shot drop slot, gives us an instant speed roll to put on our courtier. Love getting a Werefox here. That is a fantastic red card right there. Not for us though. Okay, Garruk's Uprising. That's kind of interesting. One, two, three, four. It's not a lot of things that trigger it. But I don't want any of this other stuff, so. Okay, there's a heart. I mean, maybe we adventure it. I don't want to play any of this other stuff. If I want to play Keep Guard, I don't have that many enchantments. So the answer is no, I don't think I do. Wow, Troyan. Okay, so the green blue deck was very open. I'm not going to take Troyan now, though. Where am I? Doesn't seem like a very good card to splash, but I don't think I want a Wishwalker either. There we go. Genealogist. It would be better if we had more two drops, but a roll is a roll is a roll. Now I can have a keep card if I want. I don't know if I do want, but I can have if I want. So we didn't really end up with any fixing except for a Fawn and a Crystal Grotto. But I think that's okay. Duelist can go at the two drop slot. Picnic Ruiner is never going to be a two drop. Play one Grotto, no mountains. Do I even play the Ruiner? I don't think I do, actually. I'll just play the off-color adventures, Hunter, and Duelist. And then play 17 lands with Candy Trail. Okay, don't want this Keep Guard. Definitely want this removal. Do I want this reindeer or this heart? Put these maybe cards over here. That is a lot of three drops that have. Okay, so the princess takes flight. How good is that gonna be? Triggers our knight. It's Can be bargained with two buttons and a glory. Alright, so enchantments, 4. Plus roll. It's like 8 enchantments. Okay. Keep guard, reindeer are out. Do I want the scarecrow guide? I'm not sure I do. What's our plan against aggro? Play 2 breeze. Play Gamut Gluttons. Yeah, I think that's our real plan. This is 42 cards. Do I need Tempest Heart? I have 5 cards that can possibly trigger it. The adventure can help me if I'm really flooded. So I kinda like it. These saviors aren't looking super fantastic. Alright. Enchantments that can go to the graveyard. The 2 cooped ups can go to the graveyard. Princess Takes Flight can go to the graveyard easily. Curse of the Werefox. That roll can go to the graveyard. Knightly Valor can go to the graveyard. You can sacrifice rolls to bargain. So maybe? Maybe I just keep one savior? Yeah, I think I like the other 3 drops better. And then the last cut is what? The heart. Oh, there's a scavenger also. That's another 3 drop. But also, gives us food. Bargain with the food. Maybe play 60 lands because I have Candy Trail Fawn. I don't know if that's a good idea. I do want to play 17 lands. So, Heart is the cut. Or another Savior, maybe? Or Scavenger? Maybe it's Scavenger. Let's see, what can I bargain? Bargain Candy Trail, kind of, food, roll. Princess 6 White. It's kind of low if I cut the Scavenger. I think I do cut a savior. No, I think I'd rather have savior than heart. I'll just play like this. Green white, splashing a couple of off color adventures. Let's do it. Do it. Princess, a way to bargain it. These hammer gluttons are a little awkward, but we'll probably get there. mana. Heck yeah. Or if I draw another green, I will wait to play the Princess Six Flight so I can bargain it with the Glutton. If I think I'll get to 5/5, I'm gonna nice and keep it up. I don't want to free up my mice. But then if I do that, I have nothing to bargain these gluttons. I'll wait one more turn. Okay. So, I guess I'm just going to play this. I don't want to go. Oh, shit. Punish for leaving a white. I don't want to gamble that I won't draw my fifth land the turn after I play this. So, I'm just going to chill for now. Probably play both of these next turn. Sure. Play 4/3. Oh. Just kidding, it's a 6/5. Alright, well now I'm gonna hit that and pay the ward, I guess. I guess I can always bargain for glory, but I don't want to do that when I have gluttons in my hand. Let's see if we draw land here. We did not draw land here. Well, I hope that we do. Worst case scenario, I bargain the glory. I'll bargain it to glory. Please give me a land next turn. If I could draw the Grotto, that would be just perfect. Grotto me, baby. Alright, that's fine too. Alright, time for Valley Town. Alright, well guess what, punk? You ain't never getting your creature back. Boom, we did it. The combo. This can be bargain fodder. Plus this next turn. Possibly holding up this. I don't have anything to bargain right now. I mean, technically I can make a food, and if I draw a land, I can just play a second one. Oh, I'm cooped up. Bruh. Alright, that's fine. Yeah, you got me. There we go, there's Grotto. Do I play my other glutton here? Don't want to land. I think I do. First. Alternatively, I could just play both of these. No, let's do it. Bargain. What a bargain! Do you have another answer for 6/6? Sure don't. Oh, you have a 6/6. Okay. Interesting. Okay, I'll take it. Maybe I should put on Acolyte. It's fine. What's your last card? Oh, it's not dead at all. Okay, that's fine. Oh shit, now that's wicked. Alright, well now I have to start jump blocking. But also, I saw the 7-7 Trampler, so they have to start blocking. Probably. Them having 6-6 flyer, though, is a problem. It's not a data brawl, it's so good with the tail. Wow, what a blowout. Okay, they didn't attack. Thank God. So I gotta be careful here, I think. If I attack, they can block with Besotted Knight. Or they can block with the cat and just Death Touch and then eat their food. And then I'm in trouble. They take 6 or 2. If they do that. It's worse for me if they block with Besotted Knight and then bring it back with Edgewall in end of turn. So I might not even have an attack here. I think I do, actually. I think we are at parity for now. Yeah, they're sacrificing their food. Don't give them an adventure to bring back. They attack me with the cloth here. Block, 2, 3, 4. Right. Block, 2, 5, 6. I need to draw something here. So many good draws here. I guess Savior, Courtier are not that good of draws. Cooped Up would be my best draw. One, two, three, four, five. We're just in a top deck war, I think. Give some rats, yep. I don't really care about the rats though. Oh, Popper, why you got did you poop in here? Smells like dog shit in here. Maybe. thinking about attacking with their flyer now. What? Yuck. Oh, they're attacking with that. Fingers block. Where's that poop smell coming from? Not from this room, I guess. I'm gonna cast the end on my giant. Okay. Sure. Candy Trail is a good draw. Gingerbread Hunter. It's an excellent thing to draw. Course Cursed Courtier. Not really a good thing to draw. How do they know about the Plains of Land? Oh, because of the end. That's right. Let's go to the cat. That's This is getting a little out of control. Yep. Damn, that knocked that off so good. Fell horseman for the cat. Annoying. Very annoying. End guard doesn't do much. It would appear we kind of have a board stall, but not really because they have 6/6 flyer and they're not attacking us. 2/3. Yeah. All I need is like a cooped up. And I'm pretty happy. Land here. Not what I wanted. As soon as they feel like they're stable and they can start attacking with the Glossier, I'm in trouble. Do they think I have reach? What a weird game this is. Don't do it. Take the besotted knight. Okay. Walk with 5/5 and 2/3. Play around plus two here. I'm just gonna trade it for the 5/5. Problem with that is I get a cat, and they can bring that back with the edge wall in. Yep. Now they can make something big. Maybe I shouldn't have traded off my 5/5. Made a 5/5 to deal with whatever they bestow. That'd be true. Sure. Yikes, that does not help me very much. Yet. Drawing my cards in the wrong order. Oh crap, they're attacking with the 6/6 now. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. I don't really have enough to. Jesus. I have so many cooped ups. I don't have hardly anything. I can't get a whole extra turn with this food. I have no good attacks. Well, I guess I've been out top decked. They've drawn 3 cooped ups, and I've drawn 0. I've also drawn 8 lands, and I've drawn 10. But one of their lands was an edge roll in. It's actually a huge amount of value. Yeah. It hurts. Go to 2. Ooh, that's popping. Well, I'm just gonna die to this stupid flyer, I think. Unless I draw cooped up like right here. That's a lookout that's not cooped up. You're late, lookout! I played like all my stuff already. Wow! They grinded me out with giant rolls. That card is really good. The card that gives creatures control with auras plus 2 plus 2. Just really good with rolls. Unfortunate loss. They definitely drew a lot better than we did. And because of that card that gives our creatures plus two that have rolls, making that made a huge difference in the way we had to trade our cards. But yeah. That not dead after all, though, is amazing for them. Get back their clothier. It gets an aura. It gets a roll, so it gets a 6/6 flyer. Okay. Sand is good. I would like a lot better if I had a forest, but we have 8 forests. We'll draw one. And even if we don't, we still have a turn 2 play. Forest. Not a forest. Alright, how about a forest next turn, please? Please? Ooh, the Shrouded Shepherd. That's good value. God damn it. Because I didn't draw forest, I'm forced to like play cooped up now. So I don't take another 5 damage, I'm just kidding. Oh, they're mana screwed too? They are. Okay. Well, we can take another 5 here. Gross. Then I can attack back. Where are my forests, yo? I'll even take a crystal grotto. This is crazy. Let's see what they have. Okay. Is this rat out? Return triumphant. Okay. Sure. Another fucking land. You're joking me. Wow! I can't believe how unlucky I am. Block here, I think. And I have to. Okay, the opponent's on two lands. They're even. At least I have both their colors. If I had two lands, I could play like almost all my cards, except for this. What do you have? If we have anything. Basically anything, I lose. You have an Icon's Glory too. Great. I drew no forests. Weird, weird game. Alright, we've got 8 forests and a grotto we could have drawn. That's 9 sources. We had like at least 6 turns, and we were on the draw. Twelve percent chance of that happening. Pretty dumb. All right, let's hope we can get more lucky, because I think this deck is good. Hope we can get more lucky in our next games. Okay, sand is good. This is what I'm talking about. I mean, one more land would have been ideal. Oh, okay. That's good too. I'm gonna play this on turn two now. Ooh, red white prism. I think that's a good thing for me to see. Alright. Another land next turn, please. Also, don't kill my fawn. Don't do it. Oh, land. Okay. I can't kill their fawn this turn. But I can give this. I can kill it next turn with a Cordier or give it a roll instant speed. We are playing 17 lands. Not sure why we keep getting mana screwed though. Glutton. That's interesting too. So I can bargain the curse. I can do this. I can do this. I don't want to do this when they're not tapped out though. What do I want to do? Yeah, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do this, and then if they try and burn it, I could use the Archon's Glory. Still gonna have a gingerbread hunter, which is gonna be strong. No! Okay, well, maybe they can't bargain it. Okay, I'm cooked up for that now. Can't do anything except play 3-1. Where's my lands? Okay. Go to 20. There's the hunter. Sure. Alright, well, doesn't look like they are gonna be able to bargain that, so I can just coop this up. Pass. Get my guy back? Upkeep is their last chance to bargain. No! What? Splashing Rowan's Grim Surge? Are you kidding me? Alright, this game just got hard. Hard mode enabled. I need lands so bad. No, dude. These games are a joke, man. I'm getting so screwed. I am funny. Okay, so I can draw land. I might be okay. Another one? Jeez. I can't believe there's Blanching Ruins, Grim Surge, and a swamp. Just literally four stupid colors. A 3-1. Curse of the Werefox. We can't even fight that because it's a royal. Fight that. If I do that, then most of the pressure is off, but then I have no creature to put Nightly Battle on. Or I could play another 3-1. I guess. I'm going to hit for 5 in the air here. Honestly, if they just did it on their hunter, probably would be better than what's happening right now. Alright, let's just block here. Maybe I can get this Vanguard back eventually, but I need to stop taking damage. You can hope they haven't drawn anything. Vanguard. Also bad for me. Am I gonna get my Vanguard back? No, they have a Hamlet Glen? Are you... You're joking, right? You're joking. This game is a joke. Wow. Alright, so one game. One day game our opponent completely outtopped excess. Then the next game we get Superman screwed, and the next game we get Superman screwed. Really sad. Super sad to 0-3. I don't think there's anything wrong with this deck. This deck should be good. We never drew out a lookout early enough for it to do anything. We almost got a courtier going, but then the princess took flight and they had an off-color bargain spell. Yeah, we really got really outvalued there, but mostly because we couldn't keep up on mana. Alright. Well, that's it for this one. Thank you all for watching, and I appreciate your support, as always. If you'd like to support more, please consider following on Twitch. If you're on YouTube right now, you can find my Twitch info in the description. Follow on Twitch. Subscribe on Twitch with Prime Gaming. Also free. Once per month. Or... it's September, so you can subscribe for 25% off this month, or, well, if you're watching in September, you can subscribe for 25% off, or 30% off a 6-month sub, so please consider, if you can afford it, that's a great way to support me. On YouTube, you can support me for free by subscribing, liking, commenting. But the best way you can do is subscribing and watching till the end, because I need both of those things a lot more until you, so YouTube will start paying me. If you watch until the end, put hashtag hashtag princess and the pwn in the comments, and I'll say something witty. And I'll thank you. So, because I know you've watched till the end. Take care, everyone, and I'll be back.